Prostate cancer screenings, especially for older men. WDSU News Channel 6 anchor Camille Whitworth spoke with a doctor from the on-call network to find out what that means for you.
Dr. Neil Baum is a urologist with Touro Infirmary. Dr. Baum, let's get straight to it. What exactly do these new guidelines mean for men over the age of 75 as it relates to prostate cancer screening?
It really means it's a guideline. And a guideline means it's a suggestion. And the suggestion is that most men over the age of 75 probably have prostate cancer, and when they die with it, but not from it. And younger men who may have prostate cancer should have their cancer detected, and the best way to detect it is the blood test called the PSA blood test and a digital rectal examination. And it really requires both tests to have an accurate diagnosis.
Wow, so at what age should men start to get these tests?
Men after the age of 50 should get the test on an annual basis. However, if a man has a blood relative, a father, brother, uncle, or cousin with prostate cancer, there's a greater likelihood that they may have prostate cancer and should get tested earlier around age 40. Also, African American men have a higher incidence of prostate cancer and also should start the testing after age 40.
Okay, and are there any drawbacks of this so-called PSA test?
It's a very simple blood test. The only drawback is that occasionally it is elevated and no cancer is there, and then these men have to go on and get a biopsy, and they may come up with a negative biopsy, but at least it is reassuring that they have discovered that they don't have prostate cancer.
Dr. Baum, why is this new recommendation getting so much attention right now?
Well, in the past, we were testing all men, and we were finding that there were lots of men over the age of 75 that had very slow-growing prostate cancers and were getting treated. And oftentimes, the treatment for prostate cancer presents other additional problems. So to avoid that, we were suggesting that men over the age of 75 no longer are required to have treatment. And I say this as a suggestion, because if a man is over 75 and he has other medical problems, diabetes, heart disease, lung disease, liver disease, probably he's not going to live 10 additional years and probably doesn't need treatment for his prostate cancer. However, a very healthy 75-year-old man who is physiologically 60, is taking no medications, very healthy, able to exercise on a regular basis, takes no medications, that man probably should continue to be tested. So again, we are pointing out that these are mere guidelines and they aren't ideas or rules that are set in stone.
All right. This is excellent information, Dr. Baum. Thank you for your time this afternoon.
Thank you, Camille.